Please welcome the stunning Naomi Smalls.
And what is your fashion?
Of drag.
There you go.
Yes. Oh, you smell so good.
Oh, thank you. Hi, Chicago. What is up?
Yes.
Oh, those nails.
Oh, thank you.
Naomi, how long does it take to transform?
You know, it takes me on a good day, like.
Like today. Today's a good day. You look great.
Today's a great day. I'm at Windy City Live.
Yes. We need to put that on Cicerone.
Yeah, and you know, I'm so excited to be here because I'm not from Chicago. I'm from California. And when I moved over here, I was just so excited to experience Chicago. So this is the best way to do it.
Yeah, yes, what made you want to move to our great city?
I was visiting Chicago back before season 8 of RuPaul's Drag Race aired. And I just really fell in love with like the conveniency to get around the city. And like there's always something fun to do and the house music. Like, I love Chicago.
Yeah.
All right, so tell me a little bit more about where the name Naomi Smalls came from.
Okay, so the name Naomi Smalls came from Naomi Campbell and Biggie Smalls. Those are two individuals who are the best at what they do, and that's what I want to do, so.
Naomi Smalls.
Nice. You didn't give us an answer on how long it took you to get ready this morning.
Let the fantasy just be the fantasy, you know?
Okay, tell me this, how often are you Naomi Smalls, and how often do you live your life outside of drag?
Oh, ever since like RuPaul's Drag Race, I'm pretty much in drag like 5 days a week. Mm-hmm. So Davis gets like his little 2 days of off time.
Yes. So Davis is now the alter ego, really.
Davis really is the alter ego. But what's really important is self-care. Always take care of both egos. That's what I've realized how I need to stay sane in this.
Well, business. That's got to take a lot of time just because it's hard enough just to take care of one ego. Ask
I
him.
I know. Especially boys in makeup, you know?
Yeah. There you go. So let me ask you, why are you drawn to the 90s? Because you're a big 90s fan, right?
Okay, I'm drawn to the 90s. I was like, when I was a kid, I would go into my mom's like magazine stash and I would just stare at these supermodels. And I think the 90s is when supermodels were really like a big personality. Mm-hmm. And instead of just kind of like walking hangers, there was something really attached to the model in there, and there's confidence behind it. And I think that that's kind of why I've always been obsessed with the 90s.
Yeah, so you're on RuPaul's Drag Race All Stars. How is this different from the first time you were on?
It's different because I know exactly what I'm walking into, mm-hmm. and I look better. But there's a lot of, it's nice to have a sense of confidence going into anything that you're uncomfortable with.
Sure.
And I think that that's what the best part about RuPaul's Drag Race All Stars is.
What's the whole experience like?
It's a lot.
It's a lot.
It's a lot. And like, you see the fights on the show, and it's because like, we're men with our privates taped in between our other privates, and we're in heels, and we're in makeup. Oh, yes, and the wig is uncomfortable. All of it's uncomfortable. Yeah. So that's why tensions are so high.
Right. Yeah. I have to ask you this. You are 11 out of 12 children?
I am 11 out of 12 children.
Your mother had 12 kids?
Yes. Yeah, shout out to June Heppenstall. You did right. it's been really great, though, because I think growing up with so many different personalities, I've learned how to like navigate the world.
Yeah.
So I'm
especially I'm very, since you're close to being the baby.
Exactly.
Yeah. Yeah.
And they were all tired, like they'd had the curfews and everything before me. So I got to kind of just do whatever I want.
Yeah. Have your siblings always been incredibly accepting, and do they love the lifestyle?
Totally. I'm very lucky. I didn't used to like speaking about it because I hear so many horror stories about like people getting kicked out of their houses when they come out as gay or if they start doing drag. But I realized like talking about how amazing my family was and accepting me just like really normalizes it, because if somebody's out there doing what they love and is really happy, then your child can do that too. So I'm very thankful for that.
Absolutely. Tell us about the upcoming projects. I know you got a YouTube video.
Yeah, music or something?
Yes. Yeah. In Chicago, I found out about house. I was going to.
Oh, house music.
House music.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Growing up in California, I never heard house music.
Yeah, we're both from California. House music is big in Chicago.
So DJs like Derek Carter and Michael Serafini and Cameron Trax have all like really helped me create my own music video, Pose, which you can see on YouTube. It is like what embodies Naomi Small. She's fabulous, she's fashion, she's fierce, and she's gonna pose your heart out.
Yeah, and she has a lot of social media followers too.
I do. And I don't know what it is, like, these little girls love about this man in a wig, but I'm gonna keep doing it.
And quickly, your YouTube series called Small World?
My YouTube series is called Small's World, produced by Todd Diedrich. Mm-hmm.
And what are people gonna see on that?
It's nice not to have the competition setting of RuPaul's Drag Race where you're sharing the spotlight with 12 other girls. It's all about me and what I want to present to the world, and that's what I really love doing.
There you go. Thank you so much, Naomi. Good luck to you. You can catch RuPaul's Drag Race All-Stars Fridays at 7 p.m. on VH1.